this is one of the worst. Yeah, it gets a little bit better than that love down there at Port Allen.
Yeah, never mind. Looks like you're going to get out.
Yeah, not by much, so. Yeah, that's for sure. I was in there about 4 o'clock this morning. Shit, I couldn't find a way to get to the fuel pump. I had to go across the scale.
Yeah, okay, appreciate it. Damn. Get back down out of this middle local there going into the construction road west. Other than that, you look pretty good going west, so.
Alright, 10-4.
I wouldn't go that way, Warner. You might not get out. Have fun. Rock 'em deals. What'd you say? Rock 'em deals. Got to do with you, Warner. Don't be tough on it.
Oh, that must have been one of them foreign languages. I ain't picked up on that shit yet.
Well, south of the border deals. I catch it after a while going on the radio every other week, way back in the day.
I ran down there in the late 80s, early 90s, and I got tired of that shit. They didn't want to speak English. I didn't want to speak Spanish, so we just didn't get along.
I
heard that, driver.
Detour, I take it.
I had a communication breakdown. Now, back in early 80s, I tried to learn that Hindu and Hindu hoodoo over there in the Persian Gulf. I learned enough to get my face slapped or be able to buy a hunk of fish.
I really banged up in that hole yesterday. I'm lying.
Eastbound is a four-wheeler on fire at 37 yards.
But they felt like it Mexicans, you know. Them Mexicans, they work their ass off. I'll tell you, you can't deny them that.
Hell no. Man, Mr. Warner got popped out there pretty easy.
Car fire. I'm totally surprised. I wonder how many wrecked trucks are back here.
I had about 7 I can count from here. It might be 8, it could be 6, but it looked like 7. Yeah, there's some parts laying around.
Yeah, all right. Well, you got a better view of me than that. I'm just sitting here waiting to drop that trailer. If that old boy ever gets here with the trailer they want me to take to Houston. I thought he was going to be here at 4 o'clock. I went back to sleep and told me 7. He ain't here yet.
He going to Houston. You take me back home, huh? I got to go downtown New Orleans in the morning.
Oh, God. I used to deliver that finished copper down there right off of Canal Street. Talk about a pain in the ass. I went down there early one morning about 2 o'clock. Parked my truck. Cop come along and asked me if I really wanted to park there. I said, well, I got to deliver. He said, well, I'll come back by about every 15 minutes and see if you still got your wheels.
I'm going down to Morrison Road, wherever that is. It's down there. Riverside Lumber. I'm guessing it's next to the river. What do you think?
Yeah, it's next to the river. They used to have an industrial deal there where the docks used to be, where they brought all the stuff in by ship. I don't know if it's still down there now. I ain't been down there in years.
It's been a while for me, too. I'm going to Harahan, Metairie, and St. Rose, and then down to New Orleans, back up around the Pearl River. Yeah, call the wheat, boogie on back to Houston, come in.
Yeah, I used to live up there in Bogalusa when I was in the old mill. Yeah, I know that Pearl River.
Yes, sir. I used to go to Bogalusa and pick up that rolling stock and take it to Chicago.
Yeah, well, call that a stinky city. I tell you what, the only thing I liked about Bogalusa was I didn't have to worry about them dead gum mosquitoes. Them mosquitoes are smart. They just left town.
Yeah, a little bit of a stink around there, but, it's an acquired taste.
Yeah, I know. I moved out of there. About 2 years later, I went back to visit. Shit, I started coughing. My eyes was itching. Felt like shit. And I said, man, I should have moved out of here a long time ago. But I'll tell you what, you go right down there, about 10 miles south of there, a place called Sun, Louisiana. They told me they had regulated the alcohol buying down there. They had three bars down there that stayed open 24 hours a day.
That's my kind of deal.
Yeah, especially during crawfish season. You can eat all the crawfish, corn on the cob, onions, and red potatoes that you want for nothing. You just had to buy your beer, and by God, if it was hot enough, you'd box a beer.
I know that's right. It's ordered up six-pack at the time.
Yeah. I had to leave my bike down there and come back and get it with my pickup truck.
Confrontations and conflicts out on the bottom corner here.
Yeah, I'm going to have to go get me a cup of coffee anyway, get ready for that long haul to Houston.
Yeah, well, I trained with you, but I know you're a smart man. You're going to stick with what you got.
Yeah, well, I got an empty trailer, so that ain't going to do me no good. Plus, I can't get out of here. It was all I could do to get in here earlier this morning without that truck for you.
Yes, sir.
I'd play hell pulling the trailer out of with him sitting there like he is.
Well, that's right. Well, he ain't the truck for you. His truck's for you, but it ain't your truck.
Yeah, they should have changed that T to an F. And leave the poor out of it.
I remember 10, 15 years ago, you'd see their trucks everywhere. They just don't have as many as they used to.
Now, they used to have a big yard up there in, Oklahoma, places don't smoke marijuana. They used to have a big yard up there.
Good old Muskogee.
Yeah, Muskogee. I knew they didn't smoke marijuana there, at least that's what Merle Haggard said.
Leather boots are still in style for manly footwear, I hear. Them beats and Roman sandals, they just won't be seen.
Yeah.
Like, check blue sheet or that. But I mean, you know, if you're going to resell it, you've got to have some profit. That'd be like $200 or $300 with it. That's worth doing that.
Break.
Fuck it all. Fucking car, I went straight across in front of me at BMW, coming straight off.
Like 107 today, come down that first round about Stanford. This fucking car come along.
Break.
Follow me. Start going on the roundabout, he comes straight across to go down the fucking Stanford, the idiot.
Break.
No breaker.
Hello mate, I was just sitting here listening to you guys. I'll take it you're mobile.
Yeah, we're London County roundabout when that goes down to 25 because I'll probably be busy by the old A10 now.
Copy that. Yeah, I'm London Coney, mate. I'm London Coney home base. I was just saying, traffic pretty bad out there this time of day, isn't it? Kids all going to school and that.
Oh, that's half term this week, so that ain't too bad, but that's always good up to Central and Westland on here this time of day.
Oh, yeah, of course, yeah, it's half term, yeah. Oh, well, yeah, who's the other guy on with you?
He's a mate of mine as well, we're on the same squadron from Norwich.
Oh, right, lovely. Yeah, I thought I heard a bit of a Norwich, Norfolk accent. I was up there the other week, actually, on holiday near Cromer.
Yeah, well, that's a nice part there, Cromer and Sheringham, all round there.
Very nice part of the woods, mate.
Yeah, do you ever speak to a lady on here called Primrose? Cause
No, it's pretty dead around here, to be honest. I get a few mobiles come through, like yourself, but there's a couple of us local boys, but, you know, it's like everywhere else you go, it's a little bit dead, mate.
Yeah, well, we used to speak to her a lot, but I don't know if she's still got the CV now. We used to speak to her a lot years ago, maybe 15 years ago, we all used to be on this channel, and when we'd come through there, we'd give her a shout, and that might not be on the CV anymore.
No, I can't say I've heard of
it.
It's always busy down there, buddy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm to the wrong junction, opener.
You in? Where you gone?
Come round again, I'll let you out. You've got the wrong one. Come on.
You don't come this way that often then, Bob.
No, I don't come down here. Well, I'm celibate, mate.
No, I'm still here, buddy.
Yeah.
You there, Bob?
Yeah, I'm here, mate. I'm here.
Anyway, mates, I'll wish a safe journey, buddies. Yeah, take care. Take care out there. This is Fred going down, signing off. Yeah, safe journey.
Well, here we are with the Zef mount, going to the old Rutney.
It's fine. There's no you in there.
Sorry, Zef mount.
And you're not Australian. You're a fucking Dutch piece of shit.
What do you always talk to me like this when we're out in the public?
Dynamo home, dynamo home.
I do not understand. I do not understand. Oh, shit.
Why are we going up the road? Oh, my God. Well, we're just kicking it down here, going westbound down to 907. We're seeing, try to get the thing on the one bucket here on the shipping anchor and shit. Yeah, go on.
What do you call a shipping anchor?
Get this on shipping anchor.
What in the fuck is a shipping anchor?
Let's get this on shipping anchor.
You're not a shipping anchor. You come to my house and you shoot my dog.
Is there a one pug out there? Come back.
You come to my house and you touch my dog. And my dog is operation. What did you put your ginger bite's mouth on my dog's book?
Fuck you.
You touch my dog.
I did not touch anything.
I'm take it now.
How many box of crackers does it take to get to the center of a Tootsie Roll?
Okay, someone's gonna zap this fucking thing.
Sure.
Alright, we'll keep going though.
I hear Rocky's a hoot. I got a little need to juice and come on back.
Carry my truck.
That's crap.
Well, with the Dodge, how else are you going to get a place?
Very true. Very true.
Thank you. jelly. Come on.
And my fish stay in stock is that I walk right in the parking lot for a dollar from every truck.
Driver, if you was to do that, I'd give you $50 right now.
And I got another $50 on top of that. Where you at, Soft Shell? You hear that?
Go away.
I think Soft Shell went in to get some coffee or something.
He had to go buy some
coffee. That would only be a story, wouldn't it?
Vaseline.
Oh, he went to go get some Vaseline. He can't buy no KY jelly at the Pilot.
Yeah, you can. They got that warming KY jelly that warms up when you blow on it.
Gotta go back on
it. It's all right to masturbate with, but you gotta stay next to the air conditioned vent to get the air to blow on it.
How are you going to talk about beating your knees of your feet in front of that air conditioner? Why are you going to do that, driver?
Because I can't bend over and blow on it.
I think I got it better. How about I give you the finger?